Welcome, I'm your host, Grayson Lusk, and this is Ignite. I've got a question I don't know. You have an answer I don't know. I've got a question I don't know. You have an answer I don't know. Hello and welcome to the Ignite Weekend Forecast. I'm your host, Kalen Carroll. Today's weather is partly cloudy with a high of 94 and a low of 64 degrees. Friday's weather will be a sunny with a high of 96 and a low of 65 degrees. Saturday will be sunny with a high of 95 and a low of 65. Sunday will be sunny weather with a high of 96 and a low of 65. Monday's weather will be sunny with a high of 94 degrees and a low of 65. This has been your weekend weather forecast. Thank you for watching.
What's up, Phoenix Nation? I'm Jay Stabry, and this is Change My Mind. On this week's topic, we have something that's haunted everyone's mind before. Is the Earth flat, or is it not? Let's go see what Bio has to say about that.
The Earth is round.
It's a sphere.
The Earth is round, okay?
Do you have any fact to back that up?
Columbus? He sailed, bro, right?
Yeah.
Did he fall off?
He didn't sail around the world.
But he sailed, didn't he?
He found America.
Okay, who was the... Amelia Earhart, she flew around the world.
No, she didn't.
Yes, she did.
She flew over the ocean.
Like, exactly.
That's not around the world. Mommy,
look at me. Is she really all flying around the world?
Sweet killing no. Man.
You gotta watch YouTube. Take that for example.
Oh, this got sources.
Live
YouTube.
Streams.
That's the government making videos.
Nah.
Okay.
Nah.
Do you have any fact to back it up?
How could I? I've never been to space.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
All right, give me your, how do you know that's
okay,
flat? How do you know
that's flat? Let's picture the Earth right here, okay? This is the Earth, okay? See how it kind of falls off, right? Okay. If you pour it on there and it stays, how does flooding occur if it's round? It would just fall off.
If I go around the world, I'm gonna end up in the same point.
But have you been around the world?
I will, watch this. You are my world.
Okay, but like Loki, you turning me into a flat earther. Jesus.
And that's what we're all about. Thank you.
Hey Panini, don't you be a meanie. Thought you wanted me to go, or why you tryna keep me teeny? I, it's a dreamy, wished it on a genie. I got fans finally.
So this is Tyler Kelly, and he is TikTok famous. So what got you into TikTok?
You know, I downloaded Musical.ly right before it got destroyed, you know, taken off, and then turned into TikTok, and so I was already on it, and it was really fun. So I did it. It's gonna be me.
So, what video made you famous?
Well, there was a video of me and my friend Clay and Blade and Kobe. We hit our heads up against a stop sign, and I guess that's what people like, you know, injuring one another. That's what got me big.
Right. Has your life changed due to all the fame?
Yeah, I mean, people definitely treat me differently. They put me up on this pedestal like I'm some sort of god or something. You know, people ask me for pictures and like when I'm out to eat with my family. You know, it's hard to adapt.
I'm sure it is.
You're out eating with friends and family when disaster strikes. They've all gotten their food before you. You don't know how to react, so you just sit there looking stupid.
So we're here with Mariah Key, and she is TikTok famous. So what got you into TikTok?
Well, it all started when I wanted to be better than Tyler Kelly.
Shut up.
And?
And I am.
Be it poppin', heard you get it poppin'.
What video got you famous? Go in detail.
Well, so I was just, it was just a normal day at Chick-fil-A, and I just wanted an ice cream. But I didn't want just a normal ice cream.
Right.
I wanted it, like, upside down. But then I videoed it so I could, like, post it and maybe get 3.3 million likes. And I did. All I did is grabbed it. And then ate it.
3.3 million likes for grabbing it upside down ice cream and eating it?
Yes.
That's funny.
Welcome back to Shower Thoughts.
Banjos are just guitars with southern accents. Poultry farmers are literal chicken tenders. Stephen Hawking would have been able to have a full conversation with his dentist during the procedure.
What's up, Phoenix Nation? The following video you're about to watch is a comedic performance done by the Phoenix TV crew. Vaping is a very serious action and hazardous to your health. Everyone should take notice of the new Gordon County Board of Education policy regarding vaping. The next skit you're about to watch is a comedic performance that I want you to be taking as a comedic performance. Phoenix TV does not permit all actions regarding vaping. Have a great day and go Phoenix.
So as many of you may have known, I recently got fired from my job as the PDA patrol. And I got promoted to the vape patrol.
Justin Johnson back here again. Vape has been a huge problem at this school. Right now I'm on the case of a scene. We got a code 304 in the social studies lab. I'm gonna go and see if I can stick it out and catch him.
Hey, finished our history project. Here you go.
Thanks.
Hey, I saw that. Oh. I saw that. Put the vape down. Put your hands behind your back. No. Come with me. Come with me. Yeah, come on. Come on.
Dude, it's a USB.
Yeah, yeah. That's what all them vapers say nowadays. Let's go. Whoa, get that out of here. No. No vaping in the school. Gosh, these nicotine addicts can't even go 5 seconds without their vape now.
What's up, guys? Today is National Pancake Day, and so today we're going to be doing a pancake eating contest.
Pancakes?
I love pancakes.
What's your favorite kind of pancakes?
Chocolate pancakes.
Chocolate pancakes? Chocolate chip pancakes?
What would I look like as a pancake?
Probably.
Probably thick pancake.
with like a tablespoon of butter, half thing of maple syrup.
Hey there, I'm Grayson, this is Ryland, and this is Omar, and this is Personal Best. What you'll be doing, guys, is you're gonna have your shoe, okay? You're gonna completely remove your lace, and you're gonna tie back up in a single knot bow as fast as you can. All right, now I'm gonna be timing you guys, okay? And you're gonna start in 3, 2, 1, now.
Oh my gosh, this guy's going fast.
Now, Omar, you said you were born to do your shoelaces. How confident do you feel about that statement?
Not too confident.
Seconds on the clock.
What?
Now, oh man, he's already got it completely undone.
Done.
At 1:48, you have beaten Omar.
Today I went around asking some teachers to shout out some students who go above and beyond and represent what being a Phoenix is.
This first student that comes to mind is going to be Emily Cook. She's fantastic in class, really, you know, embraces what we try to do here at Sonorville High School, which is, you know, work hard, don't be afraid to ask questions. Always doing what she's supposed to be doing, no discipline issues at all. You know, a fantastic kid, and she really embodies the helping aspect, I think, that we preach here at Sonorville. You know, she's always willing to help other students, help her teachers, does whatever she can to make class run good, to make the school better, and she's just a fantastic student overall.
Alright guys, we're going to be having a test today, so get your stuff ready.
Dang it, again? Oh dang, I forgot my freaking bag.
Mr. Teacher Guy, I don't have my stuff.
What?
Yeah, I forgot, honestly.
Oh, so you think since you drive, you can just forget your stuff while everyone else doesn't have to be told to bring their stuff? Is that it?
Yeah.
All right, I guess. Here, I'll write you past to get your stuff.
Hello again. My name is Chris Ferrat, and this is Today in History, 1949. Hollywood Land was built. Then later, they decided to tear down the sign and rebuilt it to say Hollywood.
Thank you guys for watching. We hope you enjoyed this episode and let us know what you want to see in the next episode. Until next time.